Hi, welcome to Naresh Technologies. This is Hari Krishna. I am here to take one of the core Java related topic and very important topic. The topic is compiler changes in our class code. Okay, the topic is, once again repeating, very interesting topic. Maybe you have not heard this heading in your regular learning process. It's a really new topic to you. Compiler changes in our class code. You are writing one class. As part of your Java program development, you are writing one class and you are typing the code as you wish. But after compilation, in your dot class file, compiler software will add some changes. What are those changes it is adding and why those changes are adding, we are going to learn in this topic. Okay, agenda is clear. What the agenda? Compiler changes in our class code. We are writing our class. And while compilation, compiler software adding some more code to our program. What are the code is adding by compiler that we are going to see? Okay, na? Now let us try to see that this topic having very much weightage in your written test exam. You got already job, okay? You are having some recommendation. You are in your friend company or your brother company or your sister company. Somewhere you got recommendation. You want to get the job. Already your job confirmed. This topic is no need to learn. But you do not have any recommendations. You have to apply yourself and you have to write exam. You have to clear exam by yourself. In that case, this topic is giving you very much help to you to clear your written test exam. Majority of the questions in the written test are rounding around this topic. So learn this topic very clearly. Now topic is compiler changes in our class code. Let me take one small example and then I will highlight the topic. Okay, I am taking one Java file. Let us say example.java file. Okay, in this example.java file, I am creating a class called example. I am creating a class called example. That's it. Okay, just empty class I am creating. I am not creating anything, just empty class. Then can I compile this empty class? Oh, Beshuga, you can create, no problem. Now how to compile, tell me. I am giving Java C example, Java C example dot Java. Whenever I type Java C example dot Java, now tell me, it is giving us from this code. I am getting what am I? Example dot class. Example dot class. In this example dot class, compiler software is doing some changes. What are the changes it is doing that we are trying to understand? Okay, right. Now here I wanted to list out what are the changes it is doing. Try to observe. First it will check, is our class extending from any other class or not? Is our class extending from other class or not? Extending or not? First point is checking, is our class extending to any other class or not? If yes, it is leaving. If no, it is not extending. If no, then now it will add java.lang.object class, java.lang.object class as our super class. That's the first point you have to know. And then next, second point, now it is going into the class and verifying, is this class contain any constructors or not? If the class do not have any constructors, then it will add one constructor. Second point, what is checking? Constructor available or not? Constructor available or not? Constructor available or not? If available, it will not do any change. If no constructor there, then it will add a default constructor. It will add a default constructor. What the meaning of default constructor? I will tell you. Then next, third change it will do. Yes, let us say myself, I am writing one constructor. I am writing myself one constructor. A programmer writing one constructor. Let us say I am taking parameterized constructor. Example of index. If constructor available inside constructor, now it has a super call or not? Super call. If super call is not available, then compiler will add if not available, then compiler will add super parenthesis semicolon. Okay, right. And the next, assume I have in this class a variable called int x. What type of variable this variable? Non-static variable. Now, this non-static variable, either inside the constructor or inside the method. Okay, let me take here parameter name as a p, not have confusion. Now I created one non-static variable called x, and then now I am writing here x equal to p. Okay, now p is a parameter, x is a non-static variable, and I am taking a method called void m1 method. What type of method? It is a non-static method. Here I am writing system.out.println x. Okay, then now tell me, fourth change, what compiler will do? Compiler will verify, are you accessing any non-static variable or non-static method directly by its name? If you access directly by its name, then fourth step, what is checking? It is verifying, are we accessing non-static variable or non-static method? How? Directly by their name. Directly by their name. If yes, then compiler software will add this dot. Will add this dot. These are the four changes compiler will do in our class. Okay. So if you know these points, then answering the questions in the written test is very, very, very easy. If you don't remember these four points, and then definitely you will give mistakes in the exam, wrong answers in the exam. That's why by heart. So let us try to understand now what are the changes compiler is adding. First change number one, it is working from super class. First change it is doing from super class point of. Second change it is doing from constructor. Third change it is doing from super call. Fourth change it is doing from this dot. Okay, it is doing from this dot. These are the four changes compiler is doing. Okay, right. Now, why it is doing these four changes? Let us try to understand one by one. Okay, first, let us try to see some test cases. Are you ready? Right. I will give you some programs just by following these four points. Try to develop the dot class file. So, if you know first of all how to develop the dot class file with these changes, then automatically you can solve the questions I am giving. Okay. I will give you some test cases, written test exam and SCGP exam related questions I will give you, so that if you know these four points, you can easily answer those questions. Okay. Right. I am creating one class. I am developing one class here. Class example, that's all. Class example, this is case number one I am implementing. I have given you just empty class. Okay, then if I compile this class, very important point you should know, JVM software will not execute the class you given. JVM software will execute the class that is generated by compiler software. Na JVM execute bytecode, you know. So what JVM is running, if you have an idea, then now next coming points are very easy. So now this is what I am trying to understand. This is example.java. Then I compiled with the command what am I? Java C example.java. Then from this command, we got example.class. Now try to observe and tell me what are the changes coming in this example.class. First point, what compiler checking? Compiler is checking, is this class extending from any other class or not? Check, is this class extending from any other class? No, extends not there, na. That means not extending. Then now compiler software will make this class as class example, what is writing? Extends, let me write down, no problem, extends. Java dot lang dot O capital letter object. It is a predefined class given by Sun Microsystem. Then class example extends Java dot lang dot object class, it is placed. Then next, what is next checking? Constructor available or not? Tell me, in this class, did we create any constructor here? No. Then compiler software is adding one constructor. What? Example parenthesis, no parameter constructor, along with what statement? Super parenthesis semicolon. Already have told you third point. Super call available or not. Now not available. It will place super parenthesis. Compiler software place constructor along with super parenthesis. And then next fourth point. It is checking any members accessing. No members accessing. Na? That's all. Close this class and now place it. So now you have to observe what are the changes coming. First change number one. It is placing java.clang.object class as super class. And next it is placing constructor along with super parenthesis. You should have this idea. Why I should have this idea, sir, means to pass a written test exam. Okay. Next, based on this thought, I am going to give you some test cases. Those test cases you can answer only if you have this idea. Okay, I hope you understand this topic. Repeat once again, what is the topic we are discussing? Compiler changes in our class code. Compiler will perform four changes in our class. Change number one, it will check super class is there or not. If not there, place java.clang.object class as super class. Next point, constructor available or not. If no constructor available, it is placing a default constructor. Default constructor is nothing but a constructor without any parameters. And next, third change it is doing. If constructor available, it is placing super call available or not checking. It is checking super call available or not. If not available, it will add super parenthesis semicolon, no arguments in the bracket. And fourth, if you are accessing any non-static variable or non-static method directly by their name, then it is placing what? This dot. Okay. Then by following these points, we implemented one test case. I hope you understand this test case. Now here no super class. That's why extend java.clang.object. No constructor. That's why compiler place constructor along with a super parenthesis. Understand this case? This case is nothing but empty class compilation. Now let us try to see second test case. Now I am going to write example.java file again. Okay. In this example.java file, I am writing class called example. Now myself writing one constructor inside. Please try to think, it is the one of the very dangerous point. Any number of times you listen, you will forget. That's why carefully listen, store in your brain. Example of I am writing parameterized constructor int p. Some statement, least bother, close this, that's all. I am created now case number 2, a class with constructor. What constructor? Parameterized constructor. Why I am calling it is a parameterized constructor? Here I have parameter, na? That's why. Okay, then tell me. If I compile this class, again same story, what? Java C, example.java. Then, compiler software. Generates what a example dot class. Tell me in this example dot class compiler software what are the changes moving. Apply these 4 points. Point number one, super class there or not there? Not there. Then what it will write? Class example extends java dot lang dot O capital letter object. Second point, in this class constructor available or not available? Available. Then compiler will write constructor or not? No. As it is moving here. Example int p open bracket closed bracket as it is. Listen, I am going to place some statement here, SOPL and double quotes high. Then this SOPL and double quotes high also will come here. SOPL and double quotes high also will come here. Then second point also, constructor available or not? Yes, available. It is not adding another constructor. Then third point, what is checking? If constructor available, in that constructor super call available or not? Not available. Then now compiler will place what? Super parenthesis semicolon. Okay, compiler places super parenthesis semicolon. Fourth case, accessing non-static variable, non-static methods. No, I am not accessing. That's all. Compiler software completed its job. Compiler software will complete its job. Then please try to understand now. From this change, what other changes are coming? Number one, our class is not super class of any other class. So it is added java.clang.object. And then next, now constructor already available, so not adding constructor. And then now here I am placing what? Super para, compiler. This constructor doesn't have super parenthesis, so compiler placing super parenthesis. So these are the two changes came in our class. Now I have some doubts here. I got some doubts in my mind. So please try to think and answer. Doubt number one. Every class is by default subclass of dash java dot lang dot object. Every class is a subclass of java dot lang dot object. In Java, you cannot create any class as an independent class. Every class should be subclass of java dot lang dot object. That's why compiler software adding extends java dot lang dot object. Point number one, why compiler software adding java dot lang dot object as a super class? Because every class should be subclass of java dot lang dot object class. That's why it is adding. Point number one. Point number two, try to observe, if I create a constructor in my class, will compiler add default constructor or not? Will compiler add default constructor or not? Compiler doesn't add default constructor if my class have our own defined constructor, either parameterized or non-parameterized. Okay, so repeating once again, two points you have to observe from this previous test cases. Every class should be subclass of java dot lang dot object class, so it is a compiler placing extends from java dot lang dot object. Point number one. Point number two, compiler software doesn't place a default constructor. Again, I'm stressing, compiler doesn't place a default constructor if our class has some constructor. Compiler places default constructor only if our class doesn't have any constructor. Okay, point is clear, I hope. Okay, right. So this is the second test case. What the difference from previous test case and this test case? In previous test case, I have not created a constructor, compiler added. In this case, I have created a constructor, compiler doesn't add a constructor, compiler added only super parenthesis. Okay, right. Let us try to see one more last test case and let us conclude the story. Now, here in this class, I am writing something like this. I am taking two classes. Now I am taking two classes. Try to observe. I am writing class example, open bracket, closed bracket. That's all. I am taking one class. Now I am taking another class called sample. I am taking another class called sample, which is a subclass of example. Okay. And then inside this class, now I am creating one variable called int x. Okay, and I am writing one constructor called example of int p. Okay, and then here I am writing x equal to p. And next I am writing one method, void m1 method. Inside this method, I am writing SOPLN. I am displaying that value x. That's all. This is a one small class I have taken. Now, can you tell me? If I give the program like this, can you please identify what are the changes coming in our class? You have to identify, then only you will be comfortable for the next programs. Now tell me, class sample extends example int x, one non-static variable there. Sample class is already extending from example class, and non-static variable is there. Sample class has its own constructor. And next, inside the constructor, I am accessing non-static variable. And here, I am accessing, I have created my own method, inside method, again, I am accessing non-static variable. Okay, na? Now tell me, if I compile this program, this is example.java, this is another Java file, sample.java. Let me also add that heading, so no confusion. This is sample.java. Then tell me, I am going to compile it. First, if I compile example.java, tell me the changes. First, class example. Example class not extending from any class, so compiler will add extends java.lang.object. Shortcut I am right. Then inside example class, no constructor, it is a empty class. You can also write bracket here. It is empty class, so compiler adding default constructor with super call. With super call. Right. Okay. This is the first one. Now, if I compile sample class, can you please tell me what are the changes coming? Class sample. If this class is sample extending from example already, then compiler add extend or no? If class is not extending, then only java.lang.object will come. Then no change, as it is coming, extends what? Example. Right? And then next int x, as it is variable, no change in the variable declaration point of. Next example int p, okay? Now here in example int p, constructor already available, so it will add the constructor as it is, int p, open bracket. Now inside the constructor, now tell me, super call available or not available? Not available. So compiler will add here super call. Then next, after this I have a statement x equal to p. Please try to identify. X is a variable which is of what type? Class level non-static. What is the point? When we access non-static variable or non-static method directly by their name, look at that, I am accessing directly by its name. If yes, yes, then compiler will add this dot. Then now tell me, what the change coming here? This dot x equal to p. Why this dot not adding to p? Because p is a parameter, not non-static variable. This will come only for parameter variable. Then close this constructor. And then following by, can you please tell me, is there any change in m1 method? Yes. What the change? System dot out dot println, x variable is a non-static variable, directly I am accessing, again compiler will place here what? This dot x. Close this m1 method. Close this class. Then finally, this is our sample dot class file. This is example dot class and this is sample dot class. Sample dot class. Okay. Then what are the changes come? Identify. Example class no, doesn't have super class. So compiler added super class. Example class doesn't have constructor. So compiler added constructor. Sample class has a super class. So not added extends. Sample class has a constructor, so not added constructor. But sample class, here a small mistake I did, let me correct. Sorry, here the constructor name should be what? Sample, na? Sorry, sample, and here also the name should be what? Sample. Then now tell me, here constructor is there and the super parenthesis missing. So now super parenthesis added by compiler, and then I am accessing non-static variable directly by its name. So compiler software added what? This dot, and also in the non-static method what? This dot. So these are the major important changes compiler is adding. Okay, I hope you understand this topic. If you know this small topic, then you will get to know more points, more important points, more test cases you are going to learn. Now this is the theory kind of concept. Now based on this theory kind of concept, if you remember all these 4 points, next coming you can easily understand so many points and so many bits you can easily solve yourself. Okay, right. In the next video, I am going to give you some questions based on interview coming, written test coming and SCJP exam coming. Some questions I am going to give you. Let us see, can you solve or not? Okay, na? So that's all for the time for this video. So what is the topic we discussed? Compiler changes in our class code. Compiler performed totally 4 changes. These 4 changes, first number 1 from super class, number 2 from constructor, number 3 from super call, and number 4 from non-static variables and non-static methods. Okay, so please try to revise once again, try to remember. In next video we are going to see more bits on these concepts. Okay, right. So that's all for this video concept, and okay, for more videos please visit our channel Narration.